Students, we are learning about the representation of geographical features. We are going to learn about the use of scales on a map. Distance is an important component of a map. What is the distance between Kerala and New Delhi? Otherwise, how much distance is there between India and America? How this distance is represented on a map? Did you ever think about this before? Today, we can learn about how to represent distance on a map. Distance is an important component of a map. A map represents a portion of the Earth's surface on a reduced size or a scale. Then what is meant by scale of a map? It is the proportion or ratio between distance on a map and the corresponding distance on the ground. There are three different methods to represent the scale of a map. What are the advantages of using scales in a map? It helps to calculate distance between two locations on Earth. Scaling ensures that all objects on the ground are proportionally represented on the map. Scale helps us to show large area of the ground accurately on small piece of paper. Scale is the relationship between distance on the Earth and distance on the map. We cannot represent the exact surface of the Earth on a flat paper. That's why we are showing it in a relationship. Measurement of the length and breadth of the surface, that is taking, and after that it is representing on the map or a globe. For showing the relationship between the Earth's surface, means the distance of Earth's surface, and the distance on the map, it is represented with the help of three types of scales. The first one is a statement scale, second one is the representative fraction, and this is the third one, that is linear scale. In statement scale, the relationship is shown in verbs or as a statement. Example, 2 centimeter to 1 kilometer. That means 2 centimeter of the map is equal to 1 kilometer of the earth surface. Here in representative fraction, it is given in digits. That means in a ratio form, 1 is to 50,000. That means 1 centimeter of the map is equal to 50,000 centimeter on the earth surface. Here no unit is mentioned. Because of that, we can use any unit of measurement. If we are taking centimeter as the unit, 1 centimeter is equal to 50,000 centimeter. That is the meaning of the representative fraction or RF method. And in linear scale means it is a graphical scale or a pictorial method. Here 0 to 1, this distance is 2 centimeter. So this 2 centimeter is equal to the corresponding distance on the earth surface. In linear scale, the distance can be shown in two different ways. Here from 0 to 1, 2, 3, this side it is known as primary divisions. And this distance is subdivided into 10 equal fractions, and each fraction is equal to 100 meters. Means the 2 millimeter of the scale or the map, that is equal to 100 meter of the earth surface. So it is named as a secondary divisions. So here the secondary division of the statement scale is also given, 1 centimeter to 500 meter. That means 1 centimeter of the map is able to show the 500 meter distance on the earth surface. We can find distance between two places in two different ways. The first method is a direct method. That means it is a straight distance. So take a thread. If you have a twine, take it and keep the end of the thread on the center of the settlement and keep it straight towards the center of the next settlement. Take a pen and mark a dot over the thread. And now we have to keep this thread over the linear scale. Now take the
map. Below the map, there will be a linear scale provided. Using that linear scale, directly we can get the measurement of the distance between two settlements. So here I have marked that dot. So end of the thread keeping over the number 0 and measuring towards the right. So here the measurement is exceeding the distance 4 kilometer. So I am keeping this thread or dot over the number 4 and counting towards the left. So after 0, here one digit is there. That means this distance is showing 100 meters. So the fraction is 100 meter and the total length is 4 kilometer and 100 meters. That means the direct distance between that two settlements is 4 kilometer and 100 meter. Why it is so? Here the distance between 0 and 1 over the map it is 2 centimeter, but on actual ground it is 1 kilometer. If you are using a ruler to find the distance between these two settlements, means direct distance, using the ruler we can measure only direct distance. So keep the end of the scale or ruler in the center of one settlement, then the other part in the other settlement. So we will get the measurement as 8 centimeter. So on the ruler, the distance between these two places are 8 centimeter. So 8 centimeter means it will be 4 kilometer on the earth surface, because in linear scale 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Then 8 centimeter means 8 divided by 2, we will get 4 kilometer. So without any other measurements or the calculations, it is easy for us to find the distance of the earth surface from a map. When we want to find the distance between two places, here I represented two settlements, and we are going to find the indirect distance. Indirect distance means the distance along the path which connect the two settlements. For that we need a twine, and the end of the twine we have to keep on the center of that settlements, and along this path we have to keep our thread. So first time it will be difficult for you, but you have to do it carefully. Spread the thread along the path which connect the settlements and measure up to the center of the settlement, then make a point over. Now you take the linear scale given in the bottom of the map and keep that thread over the linear scale. So from 0 I am going to start the counting, and now the measurement is more than 4. So that means the distance is more than 4. So you keep the thread, means that dot, over the number 4 and count towards the left. So after 0, how many digits we are getting, that we can count. This one fraction is equal to 100 meter, and next fraction means 200 meter. That means the length of the measurement of that road, it is 4 kilometer and 200 meter. This is the way to find indirect distance between two places.